There are indications that Johnny Harrow was traveling in the same vessel as 41-year-old Christopher Joseph and 39-year-old Beverly Leon of Bocage. Davis McLaurin says his father was on board and he is confident that the travelers were given a written clearance at Marigot, allowing them to depart from this location. With no word yet from anyone on the trip and a missing persons report made to the police, McLaurin says he is disappointed that the authorities are not treating the case with urgency.
I haven't heard anything up to a day like today. I haven't heard anything, not even a call from them. You know, and that's very bad. You know, it's like a hole in your heart, and they still add an extra piece on it. You know, just the way that they deal with the situation. I mean, these people are St. Lucia nationals, and it's not like they went out and they didn't know about them. They have all the concrete information about the people, and it's very bad that they have it and they kept it sealed and they didn't bring it out. You know, right now this situation is very hard for the family.
Davis says he spoke with his father last on January 28th. The family is devastated by the news that Johnny Harrow could be lost at sea.
Every morning he's come to, by me, tell me what a coffee I have there. He used to give me his coffee, and up to now I can't see him. And I had my coffee for them, everything prepared for him, and up to now I can't see him again.
How do you feel?
And I've been very bad and very sad about him, because he was the only one I just see. When I open my door in the morning, I just see him passing and buy his bread, and I just give him his coffee.
Family members say they have no idea if their loved one is dead or alive. According to the family, what's worse is the way the matter is being handled.
But when you lose a member of a family, everybody feels hurt, right? But what I find, if the people go through custom, they had clearance, you understand? What I'm finding, if something happened like that, you know, police should contact the port that they live here to go to. You understand? They're supposed to contact the port to find out, well, if that person and that person, if they arrive, or what time they leave port and whatever, because these people are missing.
The family of Johnny Harrow of Ciceron is keeping their fingers crossed and will keep searching for answers. For the DBS News World, Jason Hollenseed reporting.